Right. So as we discussed that today, we are going to install an Apache web server on Ubuntu. And once it is done, tomorrow we will again install that Apache web server on CentOS. So okay. Then you have a both platform understanding that how the Apache web server installed and configured inside a container, right? So all the command is remains, all the command remains the same. The only command difference is that when you are installing a web server, right, web server need to expose to outside world.
Okay.
Okay. So just Ubuntu. Type Docker run. Yeah, -it. Then --- name. Make it like web server one. The space -p -att. The space, and then Ubuntu /bin/bash. Good. So first we are going to install update.ubuntu. So just run again apt-get update. Yeah. So now we are repeating the process, huh? Because this time I am running the container with the default port, which is 80. Clear the screen now. Now we are going to run. Yeah. Press 2x enter first. Yeah. So apt-get install Apache 2. Why? So the package is getting installed, and once it is installed, we have to start the service. That is service Apache 2 start. Clear the screen. Press 2x enter. Yeah. So that is service Apache 2. Start. Fantastic. Good now. Yeah. Go there now. And in a browser, just type.
Okay.
Yep. So this is a default page, right? It can be your page also. So now let's modify this page. For that we have to install an editor inside a Ubuntu operating system. The editor is called Nano. So go and install a nano editor inside the Ubuntu. Okay. Just type apt-get install nano. Clear the screen. Press two time enter. Yeah, good. Now we will go to nano space slash var slash www slash html slash index.html. So this is the default web page of your Apache, right? So let's say for an example, let's modify something. So first let's modify the title. Come to a title. Scroll down. Good. Little bit up. Yeah. Delete that title. Press. Yeah. Just type for an example. No, just type Take Place Consulting Services. It's our company, huh?
Sir, what is it?
Take Place. PLE. 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 E for England. Yeah. DGE. Okay, no problem. Just scroll down again. Scroll down. Yeah. Keep scrolling down. Good. Just hold on now. So here it's saying that Apache Ubuntu default page. Again, delete that and type here Take Place Consulting Services for an example. All good, right? Now say Control X. Say Y. Enter. Good. Let's start the service once again. So type service Apache 2 start. Good. Now go and refresh the page.
Okay. Yep. It changed.
All fantastic, right? So this is the way you can deploy a website inside a container and even access the container from outside, right? Remember, as I told you in the very first day, that the complete Alibaba.com, the e-commerce sites, is running inside a container. You understood the power of container now.
Yeah, but one thing. So right now, what we are doing is we are changing the files within the Docker, right? Yeah. But in the real world, what happens is like we will be developing the application on our local system. So we need to copy those files into my server, right? My Docker container.
Yeah. So that you can do using Docker volume.
Okay.
So you can mount the volume inside a container, and whatever the file that volume have, you can copy it locally.
Got it.
Good. Understood now? It's clear?
Yeah, it's clear.
So that how the web server is running inside a container. So as a customer, you are not aware that the website URL which you are accessing is running inside a container. Or it's running inside a physical machine. You have no clue at all. Right? So as a container, as a customer, you are only seeing that URL. You are not seeing anything else. Good, right? And this is how the port redirection works. Good? So exit now. And now run that, go to Docker PS-A. You get one more Ubuntu image, which is web server. Can you start this image now? Second one.
Ours is first one, right? Web server one.
But there is one more you have created now, which was not run last time. Yeah.
Okay.
So just say start. And type the container ID. Yeah. Enter.
Oh, we should have done bin slash bash.
No.
Okay.
So if you want to go inside that container, then you have to use a different command that is called docker attach.
Okay.
So type docker attach and then type the container ID. Enter. Now it will let you directly inside the container. Docker start will only start the container, but it will run in a background, right? Docker attach directly take you to the inside that, right? So now can you go ahead and learn is that we can expose our container image to outside world using the port redirection method.
Okay.
Otherwise your container is only running inside a private IP, which is not exposed to an outside world.
Yeah.
Second learning is that if you want to go inside any stopped container, you have a option to go as a Docker attach.
Yeah.
Good, right? So tomorrow we will again stick to your